Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. My name is Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you are a first-time visitor, thanks so much for stopping by. If you are returning, thank you as well. Today I'm walking you through how to create Instagram carousels using Adobe Express Beta. So let's go ahead and get started. Here I am at the homepage of the latest and greatest Adobe Express, and what I'm going to do is search in the option up here and type in carousel vacation. And you'll see all these results will show up: templates, photos, videos, design assets. I'm going to use templates just because it makes the job easier of creating a carousel than starting from scratch, which you can definitely do, but I'm about efficiency and getting stuff shared quickly. And you can see all the different templates that are available. I'm going to pick one that just peaks, or to say just calls out to me right away. I'm going to create a carousel based on my recent vacation. And if you hover, you can actually see a preview scroll through of the template itself. I'm going to use this one right here, which has a summer theme. Now, as a pineapple, I'm going to go ahead and change that here in just a second, but I'll show you. Let me close this out. And if you click up here on the top right corner, you see the number 4, you'll get to see all the pages that are available in this carousel template. Now, what you could do here is if you have more photos that you want to share than what are available here, we can create a duplicate of the single one. But I'm going to go ahead and just stay with these 4 pages for now. I'm going to go ahead and close this out, and highly recommend creating a, or I should say renaming the project. So I'll just call this Carousel Trip Colorado. That way I can make sure that I can find it later on in my stuff. Now, first off, you'll see that there's a theme option here. If you click on theme, this is a nice way to instantly make this your own, which I'm going to do here. So let's go ahead and scroll through. I like the retro themes and this one right here. I'll click that. As you can see, it changes the colors of the text. I'm going to go and head back to the top, and if you click shuffle, it'll go through the different colors within that theme. So let's go ahead and check through. We'll do the same thing over here. We'll do retro and let's shuffle through till we get to the same one. There we go. So I've got that, and we'll do the same thing here. I'll come right back after I'm done doing this and we'll continue. Now that I've changed the theme colors for my entire project, I'll let you see here. I'll scroll through. I've got matching backgrounds there. Now what I'll do is start working on the text. And so right here it says summer memories. I'm going to go ahead and select that and just call this Colorado biking. And then what I'll do is change the text. I'm going to go ahead and select this entire text here. I have a favorite font that I use on all my projects. It's kind of my way to brand my content. It's Bibas Nuo. And there we go. And then I'm going to go ahead and readjust this and the text color. Again, it's with the theme. I'm going to go ahead and click right here and you'll see the theme colors. You can change that to match the theme. I'm going to go with a drastic contrast right there. I think I'll keep that. Now, the next thing I'll do here is change some of the assets here or icons. So if I click on the pineapple, as the pineapple really doesn't have much to do with Colorado. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that pineapple there. And I'll come over here to elements, and here you'll see backgrounds, design assets, shapes, and icons. I'm going to click on icons, and since this is about Colorado, let's go ahead and see what comes up for Colorado. I'll type in here. We'll have the map. Probably not what I want to use. I'm going to go ahead and then change that and type in mountains. And there we go. So I've got a much better option for my project. I like this one right here. And here it is. We're going to go ahead and put that back up here, and you'll see it's the same color as the background, so it kind of disappears there, but we'll go ahead and fix that here in just a second. And we'll go ahead and change the fill color, and boom, there we got the mountain right there. And then this arrow right here is just pointing to the next page. I can go ahead and leave that there. I'm going to show you a little trick here, a little hack on how we can get that showing up on each page or each slide of this carousel. In just a second. First, what I'll do here is click on the photo. And the nice thing is it's already laid out. So I'm going to go ahead and click up here on this icon, which is replace. And I will go ahead and click upload from device. So I'm going to go ahead and find my photos from my recent trip. So here we go. I've got this already set up. And first things first, let's see which one is the one I want to use. I think I'm going to go ahead and go with this one right here. And I'll click open. And this one is shot vertically. So I'm going to go ahead and make an adjustment here. Here is the crop option. I'm going to slide that up and put that right about right there. Nice. I like that. And it's cool. It happens to match the red in the cup. And that was naturally by accident there. So here's the little hack. So I've got this arrow here. I'm going to go ahead and highlight that. And I'm going to see if this works. I'm going to go ahead and Command C on my Mac because that's going to make a copy. And then I'll go Command V here. There we go. So I'm going to go ahead and do that for each page. We're going to slide this over here. And then, boom. That will take us all the way to the end there. So it's just Command C on the Mac. And I do Command V on the next slide. So here we go. We're going to continue here and swap these out. I'm going to click on the palm trees here. We'll throw those away. And I'm going to go ahead and type in mountain biking and see what comes up for the options. We have these icons. Find one that I like. I think I'll go with this one right here. We'll put that up here. Now I'm going to go ahead and change the color before it's hard to find. I'm going to go with that reddish pink color. We're going to rotate this, make it a little bit smaller, make it fit right there. And now we'll go ahead and swap out these images. The nice thing is I'll just use the replace option and swap out the photos. I've got mine right there. I'm going to choose the crop option and I'm going to do that so that I can adjust the size of that picture here. And I'll go ahead and grab the handle here. We'll move that right about right there. We'll click out. Perfect. Now the picture is a little dark. I'm going to fix the adjustments here because there are some adjustments right here. I'm going to choose reset all so I can see my original photo. And I might bring up the brightness just a bit there. So it's there we go. It looks like there's some effects on these photos. I'm going to go ahead and swap this one out and do the same thing here. Again, this one's got some settings. I'll choose reset all. So we've got the original. Bring up the brightness just a bit. Awesome. So we're going to the next page and repeat the steps. I'll go ahead and go through all of these, swap these out. Again, delete that and add some more content here. And for this one, maybe I'll do, let's try another mountain, see what else comes up. Let's go with that one right there. We'll move it right there. And for this one, we'll go with the red. And again, we'll just swap these out and then I'll go ahead and edit this text here because we are not at the beach. We're going to call this mountain getaway. Let me make sure we spell that correctly. Mountain getaway. Adjust this here. And again, because I have my favorite font, I'm going to go ahead and select it all and type in the font that I enjoy using. It's Bebas Nuo. We're going to click that, make the adjustment. Let's see here. Let's fix this. Let's go with a dynamic. There we go. Let's choose dynamic. That lets me adjust the entire text, or I should say it fills the entire text box. And we'll go ahead and swap out these images. The nice thing, as I mentioned earlier, those images will immediately adjust, or I should say will remain the same size. We're going to go ahead and fix this, reset. And then I will do an adjustment on the crop. Let's do that one more time. We've got the crop, move that a bit. And I'm just going to adjust this so you can see my biking buddies right there. And then we'll adjust this image here. We'll replace that. And let's go ahead and go with, let's go with that one. It's our buddies here. So this one's dedicated to my friends there. So I've got that one. And then I got that next one. And then I'll go to the last one. Now, this one says with my favorite people. So what I may do is go back here and just type in here with my biking buddies. There we go, with my biking buddies. And then go to the last one here. And then we'll do the same thing. Swap out these images. We'll throw that one away. Let's go ahead and do another one here. Biking. And we'll pick a different image. Let's see here. Let's go with that one right there since we're in the mountains. Make sure swap out that color. We'll go with the red again. Let's go with that one there. And then do one more thing. Swap out the images. Adjust this text. Whoops, I selected all. Selected all. Again, I'm going to go ahead and change the text or font that I use here. We'll adjust the color to match the others. Let's go ahead and select dynamic here so we can adjust. There we go. We'll move this here. Best views and take out mountains there. It's a great thing. You can edit as you go. And here we go. Actually, well, we'll leave that. We'll swap this out. I'm actually going to replace that image up there at the top. There we go. We'll do this. We'll swap this one here. That's perfect. And then here, we'll go ahead and replace that one with a different one. I think I'll go ahead and choose this one right here. Excellent. So I've got my project here. Let me go ahead and show you the entire project here, Colorado biking trip. Unselect this. My next step is to click on download here. Make sure that all pages are selected. So I will download the entire carousel. Click on download and it'll create a zip file. I'll go ahead and extract the images and then share on social about my Colorado biking trip. And that's how to create Instagram carousels using Adobe Express Beta. If you have any questions or comments about this video, feel free to drop it in the comments section below. Don't forget, hit that like button, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please do share this video with your friends. It helps YouTube share it with a wider audience. Thanks again for stopping by and watching this video. And as always, be good to one another. Have fun creating. Peace.